Hi.
Okay, first thing I'm doing is putting on my seatbelt because I often get called out on not wearing my seatbelt. So now we can eliminate that concern. Hi, everybody. I've been meaning to do an update for like 1 month and I've been waiting for the perfect time and I have not been able to find that time. So here it is. I'm driving and this is about it. The only time I'm not talking to somebody or have something in my hands or trying to clean up after a screaming child or talking to customer service people or designing or shipping something or talking to a store owner or talking to our printers and fixing issues or sleeping every now and then. So found a nice little window to do an update. And there's so much that I was going to do it on Facebook Live, but I would probably, it'd take like an hour. So I'm going to try to do this and cut it down as lean as possible so it's not too long. I got good news, not so good news, and then great news. So the good news is, rewinding back 2 months now, Kickstarter, we funded, Vibottle, our goal was 7,000, we hit 28,000, we funded in the first 2 hours, and then we hit 28,000. Now, of that 28,000, the not so great news was almost 1,000 of it was gone immediately because there were people who pledged that did not actually, their cards didn't go through, they declined. So take that, subtract whatever Kickstarter takes, which is like 1,300, minus almost $1,000 in just shipping. So boxes for 500 bottles. All of the peanuts, all of the bubble wrap, all of the paper, right? Then we had to put it somewhere. So we had to get a storage unit, put it there. Then we purchased all of this glass. We did, so we're talking, 12 G's in glass, right? Our first order that landed was the blue bottles and good stuff. Those went out probably 5 weeks ago, 6 weeks ago to everybody in the US. So we haven't sent Canada or the international blue bottles. So we underestimated our international and Canadian shipping. Kulabrands has assured us that they can help us with Canadian shipping. And if you're international, you're going to get an email of your actual cost of shipping. At that time, you will be able to choose whether or not you're going to pay for the shipping or cancel your order, which I would hate to do, but if it's going to be like $400 for us to send one jar to Abu Dhabi, then I understand. So then we got a photographer. We put money into our website, money into marketing. We built a new point of purchase display. We ordered tags. We ordered t-shirts, lanyards, pint glasses, mugs, steel bottles, 64-ounce bottles. Let me give you some numbers. 720 64-ounce jugs. 1,200 16-ounce jars. 420 18-ounce jars. All because some of the styles of people, and this is my bad, some of the styles of people chose, say they chose a Hamsa 18-ounce or maybe like a Celtic tree. So let's say of all of our backers, there might have been one SKU or style that somebody had ordered. And let's say there was less than 10 of them, then we wouldn't print that style. But if there was like 35 or more, then we had to print that style. So we printed the style. But our minimum is 100. So in some cases, we had to pay for 100 bottles or jars or something, steel water bottles. And only a third of that is going to Kickstarter. And now we have the rest of it. So that's good news. It's a challenge, but it's good news, and I'll tell you why. It's a challenge because now we have thousands of bottles that we must put somewhere, first of all. Second of all, they'll have to be sold, and third, shipped. There's more cost than that. The good news is the equivalent is like, it's going to come out to like $80,000 worth of inventory, which fuels our company, pays our employees, buys new stuff, works, creates a budget for a working marketing campaign. Essentially, it's going to be the seed capital our company needed to grow. So the reason why it's a challenge is that in the it's like passing through the eye of a needle. You have all this expense and all this benefit, but the cost of creating it all at once is massive, and the logistics with it to make it all work. On top of that, we had 288 bottles, our first order. So we did it as a test. Our first order was misprinted, and retail value is like about $10,000. So we had a $10,000 setback, along with a 3 to 5 week setback. So we didn't get emotional about it, and we didn't really tell anybody about it. We've been dropping little hints here and there on Facebook, but we didn't just come out, because A, we don't want to throw our printer under the bus. I was in printing for almost 10 years. I had my own screen printing shop and my own clothing label. It was called GS. Here's the shirt. This thing's like 10 years old, probably 15. So I had this, and nothing, it was never perfect. Things sometimes went really well, and some things went horribly wrong, and you always do what you can to make it right, but it doesn't make a printer a bad person just because they make a mistake. Now, if they don't take accountability for it and they don't fix it, that might make them a bad printer. But, you know, things happen, especially when you're running hundreds, if not thousands of jobs a month or a year. It's just a percentage numbers game. You're going to have issues from time to time. Happens to the best of us. So we didn't get emotional, we didn't get upset. Of course we're anxious because we want product and we want to get it in and we want to get it out. That's fair. But we didn't get mad. So we had the conversation with the printer. They paid to have it shipped back, which wasn't cheap. Then they reprinted a whole new job, and it just dropped onto our floor, the 18-ounce steel caps, just dropped on our floor a few days ago. On top of that, I got into a place, now as an entrepreneur, like I make mistakes, right? I make big decisions, I make educated decisions, I make ill-educated decisions, I make, you know, decisions based on my instincts, things like that. And so it's just like having a job is like driving a car, and being an entrepreneur is like sailing a boat. Like a car, you have guidelines, you have rules, you have stoplights, you have things to tell you what to do and where to go. In a boat, you can go any direction at any time, and you have to use your intuition and your wits to get to where you want to go. You got to read the stars, but you also have to listen to your gut. It tells you a storm might be coming, you know? So, with that being said, so the if I were to do it again, I would probably not offer as many styles as we did on Kickstarter. I know it made everybody happy, but it also made a lot of unnecessary work. We could have actually just released a few designs for Kickstarter and then came out with a bunch more like next month or something like that. So that was a mistake that I made. And I'm okay to admit that. Also, I underestimated the cost of shipping, especially international in Canada. I didn't realize that a lot of our screens that I had handed in to the producer on the other side of the screens, or on the other side of the bottles, I changed the back screen. So it had like this dope, everything had the same logo on the back. Well, apparently that changed all the screens, and now we have like $1,200 in setup fees alone that I didn't account for. So we basically got into this pinch. Oh, the other thing was we had invested money. We had investors that helped us produce the video in the first place. And all of the other costs for almost 3 months that it took to get to Kickstarter and to do the honorable thing, we paid them back first thing. So add all that up and immediately that $27,000 isn't everything you need it to be. It's a lot. It's great. I appreciate it. I love it. But it's not everything that we needed. So I came to Kula. The Kula community not only has helped us grow and support us, but Jan and Peter and Doug and Deborah and Don and all the people that are at the top running things have been really good guidance for me And Peter personally took the time to help us out, to which I cannot even express my gratitude, because I was freaking out for a while. Bottom line, I did not know how. I was like, wow, we have like $5,000 left and we have $10,000 in bills. The good news is, on the other side of that eye of that needle, there's greatness just awaiting. And here's proof: within 2 days of us getting product landing, we already have a couple accounts, new retail / wholesale accounts that want us to be in their stores. And it's Christmas, and this is the best time of the year to buy and sell anything, especially something as beautiful and as rare and as sought after as Vibe Bottle. The next great thing about what's happening is the first quarter, beginning in January, is when all the stores are buying for their next year. So if we're going to be sitting down with people like Whole Foods or Nordstrom or Good Earth or any of these other, like, or, you know, natural food grocers, yoga studios, department stores, whatever it's going to look like, this is the time to have product and samples and great photos and sales records and a successful Kickstarter under your belt and a huge community behind you. Because that's what it takes to get into like these big companies. You got to have a lot of good stuff going on, and we have everything good going on. We just need to make it over these hurdles and through these challenges and humble ourselves and take some advice, get the help, fix the problems, learn from them, and move forward. So I don't think I covered everything either. This doesn't cover the fact that Brinley's about to have our baby. We just moved. I have like my snowboarding knee was acting up, and we had to move from our 3-bedroom to our 4-bedroom because we're having our baby while all this is happening. And she's pregnant. She can't lift anything. So while all this is happening, that's happening. And in the back of my mind, I'm just like, man, I need to be shipping bottles. You know, it's like 6 days just to move. Of course, and there's just your everyday stuff. You know, we're parenting. I want to be taking care of my physical health, so I'm trying to get up earlier, go to the gym. You know, my son just came to visit for 4 days from Colorado. We're personally trying to grow and expand and manage stress and be peaceful, while on a business level, on a physical level, mental, spiritual level, we're trying to expand while going through challenges. And I know it can be done. In fact, I know they go hand in hand. I know that challenges and growth go hand in hand, because you don't grow as a person, you know, just sitting on your butt all day and not taking on any challenges. You might grow physically from eating potato chips, being a couch potato, but like mentally, physically, and emotionally, and as an entrepreneur, no evolution is going to happen until there's environmental change. That's like the history of animals, right? And we are very much like animals in a lot of ways. So thanks for hearing my update. Thanks for being patient. If you guys have any questions, you know where to reach us. Facebook, we have our Vibe Bottle page, vibebottle@gmail. I'm going to upload this to YouTube and then share it on Kickstarter, share it on Facebook, Kula community, wherever and whenever. And I know it was really long, but you know, there's the roller coaster of basically the last 6 weeks. Thank you guys. I can't thank you enough for being there for us. Personal shout out to Peter and Jan. Shout out to all of our stores that are ordering and supporting us. Shout out to all of our Kula members, all of our Kickstarter backers. You know, we are real people with real challenges and real fears, and we make mistakes. And despite that all, you know, we promise, even if we can't do things perfectly, we promise to make things right. So thanks for being patient through it. I promise it'll be worth it. When you get your bottle in your hand, you'll get what it's all about. Love you guys. Peace.